Last week on The Big Cheese.
You've been waiting a long time. You dropped it off, remember?
I did.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
There you go, Kevin.
They receive shipments from all over the world. Gas pumps, light globes, signs, and all kinds of precious antiques that are headed for the scrapyard. When all hope is almost gone, there's one man and his wife that can save them from total destruction. They call them the Big Cheese.
You've been waiting a long time. You dropped it off, remember?
I did.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yep. There you go, Kevin.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Huh?
Oh, look at there. That is awesome.
You like
that,
it?
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly.
Did we leave you enough room when we welded this in for your nozzles? Is that enough room? That's what I was worried about.
I think they have on a swivel, so I think it should be okay. Yeah. I think it should be okay. I can tighten it up, but the swivels, they have handles on them.
Excellent.
But I can keep it in one position.
One spot, like, yeah. You can keep it out on this side. Right?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I like the stand. Yeah, that's perfect. That works good for me.
You know, it's just a simple stand.
That's all I need.
Welded the two stops up here. Just a wing nut. Bang, bang, bang for it. Gold leaf.
Nice. Oh, yeah. Really great.
You come back,
that's what
look
I like.
Around.
The spokes. That's, you see that?
Yeah.
If you keep looking at it, you're going to see more detail. You can even see the two little pinstripes, and this is all paint.
Oh, yeah.
Coming down the rim, you know.
Beautiful.
So if you keep looking, you're going to find more little detail. I know you got your holes and stuff coming up in here, so I know it's going to hide probably some stuff. So we're trying to keep it all on the outside.
No, that's fine. It's perfect. Perfect.
You sure?
Yep, perfect.
Oh, man.
Absolutely. Thanks, Harry.
Thank you for waiting on us.
This is exactly what I want, just for display and for, you know, for fire musters and stuff like that. Just a little bit more ornate.
It's gorgeous. You're the only one that's got this kind of scheme on it.
Yeah, because if you ever get another one, you know, if they show the next guy and say, is this something you like?
There you go. You know? Absolutely.
Because that's exactly what I was looking for. Yeah.
Perfect. I was just worried that I just want to make sure you have enough clearance on these mounts that we weld them, you know.
Yeah, because I can always go straight bore nozzle, you know, where there's nothing, no handles, so I can put those on. It's not a big deal, but at least it's something where I can at least put some nozzles on.
So you happy with it?
Oh, God, yeah. Heck yeah, thank you very much.
Don't ever bring another one. Right, Don? You got anything to say about it?
That was a lot of work.
I can tell you, you did good. Thanks, Don. I really appreciate it. You did nice on the pin striping. You know, that's nice and stuff. That's beautiful. Awesome. Yeah, that is perfect. I'm very happy.
Good. That's the main thing, making you happy.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was looking for.
You set this fire chief pump.
Oh,
dynamic duel.
I know it. I got the fire alarm box.
Oh, got it going on, ain't you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is perfect.
Right.
That's exactly what I was looking for.
All right.
I appreciate that. Oh my
that's
God.
Great.
Now, how you want to load the bugger?
I got ramps. Easy to load.
Oh yeah, just like my.
I mean, no. Yeah, I got. I'm squared away here.
You're the man. Take a look in that back room and you'll see some of the stuff we've been doing, you know.
Oh, I know. I was going to show him since we're here. She fit in there because it came over.
That'll be good.
And then this should fit right up into this.
All right.
Yeah, we'll just turn it right around.
See this gap?
Oh, it locks right
up. Locks right in there.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks just like it was a piece of the...
Right up in here.
Look at that.
I like that idea.
It's fabricated.
It's simple.
Just simple.
That's all I wanted.
You know, and bang, bang, you know, it's done.
Let's see if I got these. I got to move those ramps because I don't know. A little bit off.
There. Should be good here, Kev.
Okay. You good?
So where you want to put like an on those?
The ramps
or
you put
them
on the...
I don't care. I got an extra blanket here in my truck too.
Do this right now.
All right. Well, we can do that. Yeah,
it's pretty. Yeah, I had the four guys pick mine up and just put it right in the bed.
God, good thing we didn't put a hose on this.
I told you that, dude. You're going to put a hose on here. It's more weight.
I wish you would have bought a light seat.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got her.
Yes,
I
got
her. Just getting out of my... Got her, Sean?
Yeah, I got her, sir.
Check this out. Big Cheese is amping up their advertising power and you reap the benefits. Become a Big Cheese VIP member today for specials, upcoming events, giveaways, and much more. It's so easy. All you need is a cell phone. Text RESTORE to 55678 or visit BigCheesePetro.com and sign up today.
Y'all remember the motorcycle that came in and Bo unloaded it. It was full of peanuts in that big box. Well, it's finally completed. And what a beautiful barber chair it is. A children's barber chair that any child would gravitate to if they seen it in a barber shop or a salon. And Dawn put her touch to it and Steve Lee. And I think it came out beautiful and we're gonna unveil it for you here today. And we hope you think the same thing. What's that old song by Montrose? I know you guys know it out there. Get on your bad motor scooter and ride. Well, that's what we tell the children that need haircuts. Get on your bad motor scooter and ride, baby. There she is. A children's barber chair. Unbelievable. I'm just gonna point out a few things and I'm gonna let Dawn get the mic. But you can see how her chrome came out. A lot of people have a hard problem laying chrome down and then clear coating it, then it looks gray. But this came out great. The chrome looks great. All the shadowing around her lettering, she's done with an airbrush. If you come up around the motor, you can see how the motor's been detailed. The graphics on the police sign here has got the guns on it. I mean, this thing is cool. If I was a little child, my wife still says I am, but I would jump up on this and get a haircut and have fun like I'm driving it, chasing bad guys, or me, myself, I would act like I'd drive it like I stole it. But most of the kids would think they're chasing bad guys. But you can see the shocks. You know, she did all the... It's just outlined to the shocks. It's above the top. You're just not gonna see this. Yeah, the seat, she made look like leather. The speedometer. I mean, what more can I say about it? I mean, she went over the top. I'm very happy with it. The back fender graphics. The tail lights, the exhaust pipes. I just can't say nothing. The heads on the motors. Even made the bolts and everything look real. I mean, this is some talent here. All the shading in here is exactly where it needs to be. I can't say enough about it. I'm very happy. I'm very happy that it's a police motorcycle too, because it's one of the rarest children's barber chair out there. Steve Lee did a great job body work and painting it, and you can see everything works on it. So, and then if you want it to go down, you just push it all the way down, and there it goes. I mean, this is a great working chair. I don't even know if I want to sell it. It looks so nice. Of course, the little tassels I'm not a big fan of, but I know children would be. And I'm going to give Dawn the floor. She's the one that brought it to life. And I'm just extremely happy about it. Get on your bad motor scooter and ride.
Terry about summed it all up, but when we first got the motorcycle, it was a little tattered. And our painter, Steve Lee, he did his magic on it. He had painted it all black. I wanted a really good base before I did anything. And then after I got it back, it's all sanded down. And to me, all the police motorcycles I've seen have always been white. So I wanted to do it white. So I did that, and I left all of the original that Steve Lee had on there as basically as shadows. And then added the chrome, and then wanted to come in there and just feather it all out with the airbrush. So all the body lines and stuff, I hit that with the airbrush. And with the seat, I wanted to make it look like leather. I was thinking about putting leather on there, but you know me, I love paint. So what I did is a three-step with different colors of paint, using Saran wrap as sort of like a stippling. And then after everything was done and dry, it was saturated with clear to protect everything. And now all we gotta do is find someone that gots to have it, and it's all ready for them. Here it is, and it's done.
Kitchen for our barbecue.
No, that
The family's coming over. I want to let them know that I don't fool around when I have a barbecue.
Well, I think they probably prefer a real pig on the grill.
So you're saying I can't?
No.
Well, I'll tell you what, then I'm put on top of the garage.
With that, keep down.
I used to ride these pigs, I'm telling you. But now, since he's barbecued, I can't ride him. But I can eat him. Pig out. Hey, Greg, good to see you, man.
How's it going?
Good, buddy.
Nice to see you again. Merry Christmas.
What are you up to?
Oh, looking for some gas pumps. Looking for gas pumps. Got any?
Yeah, I got them.
Can I take a look at them?
Right there in that trailer.
Holy cow! You got a couple in here.
There's a few in there.
There it is, right there.
You gotta be kidding me.
Nope.
That's the
Bennett
one?
Bennett 541. Bennett 541, that's what I've been looking for.
Well, look a little deeper, you might see two or three you want.
Man, you got a trailer full.
Well, I gotta have it, Greg, because people like you, you know.
Yep, well, it's nice to be able to come someplace that has pumps, has the inventory.
Well, I don't want you going no place else. I like keeping these pumps in Michigan.
Yep, that's cool. Yep, it's nice and clean.
What do you think? You think you want that one?
Yeah, I'll take it.
All right, I'll give you the price in the office.
All right, thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
We got some creatures. Motor still in it?
Yeah.
You got a dolly in there, Greg?
Yes, I do.
All right, buddy. It's going to be tight around this here tree. I park it like this because I don't want nobody getting in. see you coming up because I know you're a buyer.
Plus, it's the holidays.
You're not like that guy, Jerry Keller. He's tight on his hands, I tell you.
How's old Jerry doing?
He's doing pretty good. He was here this morning.
Sorry you missed him.
Oh, you only missed him for about... He was here about an hour before you got here. It's a heavy one. It's got the guts in it. You want me to do anything? You want me to stay out of your way?
Probably going to get interested in getting by that tree.
Mom, we'll do this for you. Push it down. You all right, Greg? I know you're a big, strong dog. I got you, got him. You must have really wanted this one.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.